Hey everyone, Chase Harrison with TruAudio. Today we're on site installing a brand new landscape audio system where the customer has asked for it to be loud. We're installing our brand new AS3s with Sub 12 Pros and our new LEA 702 Connect amplifier. Today we're doing things a little bit differently. Normally in a situation like this, we'd use our AS360 to cover areas where we want sound completely around the project. But again, the customer wanted it loud, so we ended up using our AS3s and doubling up, creating 180 sound dispersion one direction and then flipping the speaker an opposite direction and placing it out towards another listening position in the project. We're also taking our Sub 12s and placing them 60 feet apart on a diagonal across the pool area to make sure the customer gets as much sub in his project as possible. Today's install is actually a hybrid between new construction and retrofit. What that means is the homeowner knew he eventually wanted to do something in his backyard for outdoor audio. But during new construction or during his construction phase, he went ahead and wired a 14 gauge four conductor out to the side of his house, stubbing it out in preparation for us to use at some future date. So we went ahead and picked that up and ran it through a conduit, and then from the side of the house out into the yard, it was run under conduit underneath the grass and stubbed out again, ready for us to use when we were ready. From there, we went ahead and picked it up and ran 14 gauge two conductor to each speaker in a daisy chain fashion, and then 14 gauge two conductor to each one of the subwoofers. For this particular install, because we're dealing with a mature backyard and because there's already a pool in place as well as irrigation lines, the homeowner wanted us to minimize any sort of trenching out in the garden area. So for this, we went ahead and brought back the gravel and the bark in the appropriate areas, and we used landscape stakes to stake our 14 gauge two conductor wire down. And then from there, we went ahead and brought in a service loop to each one of the speaker locations to then use to wire up. Before we talk about the speaker wire, we want to talk to you a little bit about what the AS3 comes with inside of the box to help make your installation as easy as possible. Included with every landscape speaker is a landscape stake as well as a protector for the head of the landscape stake. If you want to wall mount your speakers in some parts of your project, you're able to use our AS base. For this particular project, since the homeowner wanted everything placed throughout his landscape, we stuck with our stakes. So for here, we actually started out by using a drill with an auger bit attached and went down about 12 to 18 inches, enough for our landscape stake to then be hammered into the ground. We used our fancy protector cap and we ended up using a rubber mallet to make sure that we did not damage any of the threads on top of the speaker stake. Now that we have the stake down in the ground as deep as we want, we're going to go ahead and mount the speaker to the stake. As we do so, we need to be installing our speaker wire through the stake. In order to keep from damaging the speaker, I always suggest using the styrofoam that it comes in to keep it protected while you have both hands free to feed the speaker wire through the stake. Once you've got all the speaker wire pulled all the way through, you pull the speaker out and start holding it with one hand over the stake and using the other to start the threads on the speaker. So as we go ahead and prepare to terminate our speaker wire, we're going to take the service loop that comes out of the AS3s and we're going to join it with the service loop that we created when we ran the landscape audio wire. You'll see that service loop here already connected with a zip tie. I'm going to go ahead and do the exact same thing here. I always like to leave myself a little bit of a service loop in case somebody accidentally cuts the speaker wire somewhere and I have to come back and re-terminate. From there, I'm going to loop my speaker wire up to the top, make sure I've got enough. I take my wire cutters, I'm going to cut the wire I've already run right in the middle. And then from there, I'm going to use that as a gauge to cut my speaker wire that comes with the AS3. From there, I'm going to go ahead and strip back the 14 gauge two conductor and every wire. To make these terminations, we're going to go ahead and use the gel filled wire nuts that are included with every landscape speaker and landscape sub that TruAudio offers. There are other solutions out there that other manufacturers offer, such as gel filled wire nuts, gel filled caps. You can also solder and heat shrink your ends. All will work really well for your solution. I would recommend you use whatever you're most comfortable with. We're going to go ahead and start terminating our speaker wire. Now that we've gone ahead and stripped back all of the insulator on our speaker wire, we're going to go ahead and wire everything in parallel, which means we're going to daisy chain or tie all of the red conductors together and all the black conductors together. We're going to go ahead and make sure this is wound nice and tight before we go ahead and install our wire nut. Now that that's been in the wound nice and tight, we're gonna use our gel-filled wire nut, and we're gonna be twisting as we apply the gel-filled wire nut down around the speaker wire, making sure you get all of your conductors up inside. Don't leave anything out stray or else it'll corrode or potentially short. I always like to give it a couple of really good turns so the wire's holding itself together, and we'll repeat that for the black conductors. And then your end should look something like that. I like to, for good measure, go ahead and install one more zip tie on the tag end of the speaker wire to keep these from accidentally separating, and also making sure those wire nuts have as little tension as possible. You may be asking yourself why we're using these zip ties outside. These actually are UV coated and weatherproof zip ties, so they should be able to hold up for a long time. As we get ready to install our 12-inch burial subwoofer, we went ahead and dug an 18-inch by 18-inch by 12-inch hole. Typically, we recommend over-excavating a little bit and using some gravel to help with drainage to keep your subwoofer from floating up above the dirt. In this particular scenario, we really don't have a water problem, so we went ahead and went without the gravel. Now we're ready to go ahead and place the burial subwoofer directly in the hole. Okay, next we're gonna wire up our subwoofer. Before we do, I wanted to mention to those that may be panicking by the sheer amount of wire that we have sticking out of the ground here, I want to tell you what's going on. Here is where we actually had left the wire from the pre-construction, the construction phase of the house, and where we picked it up and are now tying it to both our speakers and our subwoofer. In the process, we toned out and identified which one of the speaker wires is which back in the house, and we are using zip ties to make sure the wire we want to use for the landscape speakers is tied together, and then the wire we want to use for our subwoofer is tied together. Now we're ready to go ahead and install the wire for our subwoofer. First, on the Sub 12 Pro, you'll notice that there's a couple of wires that are sticking out in a pigtail fashion. You've got a yellow and a green wire tied together, you have a white and a blue wire tied together, and then you have a red and a black wire sticking out, ready to be terminated. The reason for this is the 12-inch Sub Pro is actually capable of being run in 4 ohm, but for today's project, we're actually running both the speakers and subwoofer in 70 volt. So we're not going to make any changes to those wires that are tied together. We're gonna focus strictly on the red and the black conductor that are actually labeled 70 volt negative and 70 volt positive, both input. So we're gonna go ahead and terminate our speaker wire directly to these. And there you have it, the subwoofer is ready to play. We're now gonna go through and terminate the rest of our landscape speakers and tie our second subwoofer into the project, and then we'll be ready to test. Before we go ahead and wire everything up to the amplifier, we're gonna go through and check the tap settings on the back of each of our AS3s and make sure it's set to 70 volt. In this particular scenario where the homeowner wants it as loud as possible, we're going to move that all the way to 64 watts. Now that we're done outside of our project, we're gonna go ahead and come inside and get ready to install our amplifier inside of our rack. Unfortunately, the equipment rack is in a pretty tight spot, so for today's training video, we're gonna handle all the connections outside of the rack so you can see exactly what we're doing, and then to finish up the project, we'll go ahead and install that inside of the rack. Before we make any terminations to the amplifier, be it your source, your speakers, or your sub, we're actually going to want to get the LEA unboxed, plugged into power, and then load your DSP presets for each of the speakers and subs that you plan on driving with the LEA amplifier. Failure to do it in that order, actually, you risk blowing your speakers or your subs. So what we've done is we've gone ahead and taken the LEA amplifier out of its box. We've got it plugged into power. If you have a network switch nearby, you can actually take a network cable and plug it in the back of the LEA amplifier and plug it into your network switch, and then use your house Wi-Fi network or your project Wi-Fi network to then access the LEA amplifier via your iPhone, your Android, your Mac, your tablet, whatever you have that has a web browser on it, to be able to go in and load your DSP presets into your LEA amplifier. Unfortunately for this project, we do not have a network switch nearby, so we're going to go ahead and use the built-in hotspot to then load the DSP presets. We access that by, first of all, plugging in the power. Second of all, you're going to want to reach behind the amplifier, and you'll see there's actually a Wi-Fi button you press. And once it turns blue, on the front of this LEA amplifier, you'll see that it starts to broadcast an SSID that's unique to this LEA amplifier, along with an IP address. So now I'm going to take my phone, go into my network settings, and then I'm going to come in and click the CS702-0005. It's the same SSID that's being broadcast and matches on the LED screen here on the front. I'm gonna select that. As soon as it joins, I'm going to go ahead and jump into the GUI interface with the LEA amplifier. You'll see here that it has joined. I'm gonna jump over to Google Chrome. It's my network browser of choice to access the LEA interface. First of all, you'll notice I'm in soundvisiontechnologies.com. I want to show you really quick where you can access the LEA DSP presets for your project. You scroll all the way to the very bottom in the footer, and then you'll see under resources where it says LEA Amplifier DSP. You can click on that, and it'll bring you into a page where it says LEA DSPs. It's a zip file. If you click on that, it'll download to your phone. You'll need to go into your Files app on your iPhone, or you'll need to go in your Explorer on your PC, or your Mac, and decompress or unzip that file. And then from there, you're gonna be able to go and access the individual SKU names to then pull the DSP into your amplifier. So I'm going to jump over to a new window, and I'm going to type in the IP address that's there on the front of my amplifier. So for this particular example, it's 192.168.1.1. I'm gonna click go. It's gonna take a moment to load the splash screen of the LEA amplifier. You'll see with a brand new amplifier that says device name. We can go in and change that whenever we're ready. If I have multiple amplifiers on the project connected up to the network, you'll also see them all presented here on the screen. But for today's project, we only have one LEA amplifier driving that landscape audio system. So we're gonna go ahead and click into this amplifier. You'll immediately be presented with output name the one and output name two. For this project, I'm going to connect the subwoofers to output one. I'm gonna do that and I'm gonna prepare output one by clicking into that particular output. And then I'm going to select the button here just above one output name that has the two lines with the two dots. That's going to give me the ability to import a DSP. So down below, you'll see where it says crossover. There's the word export and the word import. In this particular scenario, we want to go in and take advantage of the DSP presets that we have already created. So I'm gonna go ahead and select import. And I'm gonna select choose file. I'm gonna scroll all the way down to TruAudio-LEA DSP 9-21-21. There you will see I've also got an older version of that file I need to delete, but for today's example, we're gonna go into that 9-21-21. That's the latest DSP file we have ready for you. I'm gonna select that, and again, I mentioned that we're gonna install the Sub 12 Pro on channel one. So I'm gonna find the SKU name that is ST12 Pro, which is there at the very bottom. I'm gonna select that. And you'll notice that the output name has now changed to ST12 Pro with a date by it. That's the latest DSP preset for the ST12 Pro. Now that has been done, we're gonna go click back to device name, and then you'll see output two still needs an assignment. So there we're gonna go in and assign it the AS3 DSP preset. And again, that's done by clicking output name. We're gonna select the two lines with the two dots, and then you'll see the import option again down here. We're gonna select that. We're going to choose a file. And again, we are looking for the AS3 DSP preset. So there at the top, it says AS-3-5.14.21. So I'm gonna select that. You'll now see that it has loaded the DSP preset into the amplifier. I'm gonna come back to the device name. Now you should see channel one is set for ST12 Pro. Channel two is AS-3-5.14. While we're in here, I'm going to select the I button. And here you can see a couple different things where you can connect the amp to the account. If you have a cloud account with LEA, that's covered in a separate LEA training video that we have created. That we'll have a link to that in this video. Here you can also adjust your network setting. You can change your advanced settings and so on. We're gonna come back out of that, and we are basically ready to go. A couple of things I'll point out while you're in here. You'll see that there's a smiley face on there. That means that the amp is in good shape. It's ready to go. If there's a fault with the amplifier at any time in the project, as you're connecting your speaker wires and your source, and that smiley face turns to a frowny face, that means you have a problem. It could be that there's a short somewhere out where you've made your wire terminations incorrectly, or maybe there's a problem with your source. At that point in time, we suggest you call in to TruAudio's tech support line, and then they will be able to walk you through some troubleshooting steps to make sure that frowny face turns into a smiley face. Now we're ready to make your terminations for your speaker and your source. We're gonna go ahead and power the amplifier off, by unplugging it, and we're gonna flip it around and make the source and speaker and subwoofer terminations. Okay, now we have turned the power off to the LEA amplifier. We're ready to terminate the source, subwoofer, and speakers. So we're gonna start with the source. First, we're gonna take our female RCA cable to balanced conversion cable and terminate it into the Phoenix connectors that are provided with the LEA amplifier. You'll notice that I have my red and white conductors terminated into my plus sign on both of my Phoenix connectors. And then there are the two black conductors that come out of both sides that can be terminated into your negative and your ground or common slots on your Phoenix connector. Once those have been done, we can go ahead and terminate that into the LEA amplifier. And then from there, with an RCA cable, you would be able to then come in and terminate right into your female end. That's gonna come directly from your source. Next, we're ready to terminate the speaker wire into the LEA amplifier. We're going to be doing that with the included Amphenol or Phoenix connector that comes with the LEA amplifier. We'll need a flat blade screwdriver, and we'll take our speaker wire and terminate the red conductor into the positive side and the black cable into the negative side. And we will use our flat blade screwdriver to crimp down on that speaker cable. Now, if we're using a four conductor speaker wire, you'll get two additional colors there, often white and green. I like to use my white as my positive and my green as my negative. Here, once you've got that terminated, again, this is our subwoofer cable, we're gonna come into channel one, and we're going to repeat that for our speakers, our AS3s. We're gonna come right back into that Amphenol connector. You're gonna slide it in, make sure it's nice and firm. Tighten that down. And then you're gonna go ahead and terminate that right into the back of the LEA amplifier. Now with your speakers and your source terminated, you're ready to go ahead and plug everything back into power, let the amplifier boot up, and then use whatever source you have to then go ahead and test your landscape speakers. And that's it. We just got done installing our AS3s, our Sub 12 Pro, and our LEA amplifiers, and the customer is thrilled. We appreciate you joining us today. If you have any questions about what we've covered, or if you'd like to get started with outdoor audio for your first time, we encourage you to reach out to your sales representative. There, they will be able to engage our system design service, which is a free service, to help you better understand what products go where in the project. If you'd like to learn more about today's install, you're welcome to visit our TruAudio YouTube channel. If you'd like to see more TruAudio landscape products in our product portfolio, we encourage you to check out TruAudio.com or SoundVisionTech.com. Thanks for watching.